Welcome to our Fallout 4 playthrough. It is finally freaking here. The last time we played a Fallout game here on the channel was about a year ago. We wrapped up New Vegas, I think, towards the end of August of 2016. So I am super hyped to finally play this freaking game for y'all. I wanted to originally play this the year it came out in 2015, but it just wasn't gonna happen with the amount of Fallout games we were playing through. It's pretty crazy. Let's see. Don't look at the Creation Club, it's fine. It's all right. It's okay. But yeah, we're gonna get started here in just a moment. Let's go through some of these settings again real fast. Rummingtons, what difficulty were we gonna play on? We're not doing survival because I can't fast travel and I can only save when I sleep, so no thank you. I need to fast travel, man. We've got hard and very hard. I think we're gonna do very hard, I think. Was that what we were doing? Highest, not survival, so very hard then. It's very hard is right before survival, so there you go. Save in Pip-Boy app. Dang it, I don't have the Pip-Boy app, I'm sorry. Iration controller. Oh, we're playing on a PC, man. What is this? Okay. Controls, all that stuff is good. So real quickly, the only mod that I have installed is a dialogue mod. I think I installed it correctly. I used the Nexus mod manager and then I had to do something with the INI file. But the reason we're using the dialogue mod is so that way we can see the entire sentence of what we're going to say rather than it just giving us a one-word answer or kind of paraphrasing the thing that we're going to say. That way we don't hit things by mistake. So we've got that. We'll see if that's working. I think all this stuff is fine. General subtitles? No, we just want dialogue on. There we go. We might mess around with the Pip-Boy color, but right now we're going to leave it where it is. Also, we're going to leave the volume like this. I think we might turn the radio down a little bit here. Also, by the way, we are going to be playing this game with the radio on at some parts. So I know how the VODs on Twitch don't like the copyright music. So I guarantee you some of these Fallout 4 VODs are probably going to be muted. So if you want to see the, you know, hear the audio and stuff, you're going to have to probably watch this later. This, whatever parts, I don't know, video parts, whatever. You're going to have to watch that stuff probably on YouTube, because I'll have to upload my local recording and all that stuff. So, but we will have the radio on at some points. Unlike I did that in 3 in New Vegas, where I didn't even use the radio. Yeah. So, we'll go ahead and leave the volumes where they are. We'll probably adjust them once we start. What is settings? Oh, that's what we're doing right now. Never mind. Alright, cool. Cool. Remington says, if you like the settlement stuff, you could do some building streams with radio and just don't even upload it to YouTube. Hey. Maybe. I'm not a very creative person. So when it comes to like building the stuff, it's probably gonna be pretty generic and pretty bad, but we'll give it a shot. We'll see. We'll check it out. But yeah. Anyways, to get started here real quick. I got interested in Fallout when they announced Fallout 4 at E3 back in 2015 or whatever. And since then, we've been playing through all the Fallout games. We started with Fallout 1, 2, and 3. We did all those games back in 2015. And then we did New Vegas last year, which we finished up probably about a year ago around this time. It was like the end of August, I think. So, but I am super hyped to finally play Fallout 4. It's been far too long. I know a lot of people have been looking forward to it. I am looking forward to it as well. I've been looking forward to it. But now it's the time. It's the time. So let's go ahead and jump in there. I know character creation is probably going to be a little bit, but I don't know. We'll see. See what happens here. Killamento, what's up, man? Fallout 4, dude. It's good to see you. You're just in time. All right, let's see. Let's see what's going on here. We've got all the DLC as well. We got the season pass and all that stuff. So there's not a lot. I think Nuka World and the Far Harbor are like the big ones. But we also have all the other stuff there too. So yeah. Tell me the story of this.
War never changes.
Not Ron Perlman. Alt F4, I'm done with this game.
In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory.
Oh man, look at that.
It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
I really hope the dialogue volume is not that low, because that was kind of low there. Alright, so welcome to character creation. It's gonna be about an hour before I, you know, finally make my character. No, I'm gonna try and be speedy with this. We messed around with this on Friday when we were setting up some of the stuff after we beat Jotun real fast. So we spent some time setting stuff up in the game for OBS and stuff. And then we kind of dabbled a little bit in character creation. So we'll try and make this quick. But it is character creation, so I think I should maybe take a little time to it. I don't know what default face we're going to go with. 7 might be, I don't know. No. Even just like the default face might be just okay, I don't know. Which one were we looking at again? 7? Go with 7, I guess, but we'll definitely sculpt it and stuff. Highlight a facial feature, Press mouse once to make adjustments. Yes, Mr. Vault Boy, I will do that. Remington says, man, this intro gives me chills even after watching it 20 times. That was a pretty good intro. Pretty good intro. I forgot that it's not Ron Perlman, though, saying the war never changes thing, but I had forgotten about that. All right, foreheads. I don't know. Except... sure.
My handsome husband.
My handsome husband. All right, let's go with the nose. Because my nose is not that big. And also scale the nose. Like, scale the nose as in... okay. That's like a messed up nose, man. Eh, looks like a normal nose. Stick out that much. So going for male in the end? Yeah. Yeah, I was contemplating,
Hun. You think playing, your nose is too big?
Playing as a female, but, I chose not to. At least for the first playthrough, you know? If I want to play this game later on my own, I can do that. Honestly, you know, I don't really care to mess with all this stuff. When it comes to, like, character creation, it's like, eh. There's so many goddamn options. I think all I gotta do is just change the hair. First of all, let's change the hair and the facial hair. And, and then we can see what the face looks like. Because honestly, like, I don't need to freaking measure every single body part to actual size, you know? What kind of hair do I want? I don't want freaking... I should just have the hair that I dream of. Otherwise, it was like the short hair was like up here, and it's like, that's not really that cool. The down a little bit there. That's like a drug addict. My hair is definitely not curly, so let's not go with that one. The professor. 9 to 5, dapper. I mean, that looks pretty good. Beard is all that matters here, says Remington's. Alpha male. What are the top knot? The Ronin. The Ronin looks kind of cool, man. I think we're gonna go with
Hey.
We're just gonna go with Dapper, I think.
Did you get a haircut yesterday? It's cute.
I think Dapper looks alright. Now, I heard that there's supposed to be barbers and stuff with different styles, so, you know, we can always change when we get there. Alright, we need facial hair. Where's facial hair at? Extras, I think? Nope, it's not there. On the face. Oh, there it is. Facial hair T. Durr. The Lone Wanderer. Renegade. We were thinking, it's definitely not Dashing Rogue, right? I'm not a Dashing Rogue. I don't have a Dashing Rogue. That's too thin. Mine. I think there was a goatee in here. Hard road. Oh my. Dude, operator soul patch. Ugh. Soul patches, dude. Not into that. The Bard, Hombre. Yeah, I mean, goatee, that pretty much, that's me right there.
What do you think, hon? Beard or no beard?
Yeah, we've got to change the color. Wait, that's the color of my skin. I would say, am I pale white or sun-kissed? I don't really go out too much, you know? Go sun-kissed.
Oh, very strapping.
Okay, but how do I change the freaking facial hair color, though? Oh, it's probably hair color, actually. Never mind. Whoops. Yeah, we're ginger. Ginger and red, different options. Jet black. I mean, I don't think I'm jet. I don't know if I'm jet black, man. Jet black looks like it's paint compared to that. This looks more natural. We're gonna go warm black here.
This new haircut's really working for me.
I'm gonna go warm black. This looks nothing like me at all. Okay. The tip of the nose, really? Thing you can do? Tip of the nose. Round. Gotta get like a normal nose here. The character creation in this is just, I don't know, it's kind of funny. That's like, yeah, the messed up nose, man. I'm gonna have a freaking power armor helmet most of the time, I'm sure. Not right now, of course, because, you know, beginning of the game, you gotta wait to get that stuff or whatever. I still have no idea how you made Space Mike so similar to you. Yeah, I don't know either, man. I had to make it twice, if you remember, because the first time we were doing character creation in Mass Effect Andromeda, the internet was sucking. So it was like 2 weeks later, and then I made it again on stream, and it was like multiple times throughout that the Mass Effect Andromeda playthrough, everyone came in and was like, man, your character looks like you. And it's like, thanks. It does, I guess. I don't know. I didn't put a lot of time into it. This looks nothing like me, but you know what? It's fine. Whatever. Sassa Queen, hello? You're here, but you're playing Warframe. No worries. Enjoy the Warframing. Okay. About like 30 minutes. I'm probably like more like 20 into this. Yeah, honestly, you know what? I think that's probably okay. I think that's probably okay. Is there anything else you want to add? Yeah, we've got some extras. Markings, blemishes, damage. I don't think we're going to add anything like that to myself. Yeah, definitely not adding any of that stuff. So that's fine. Body? Let's look at the body. Man, you are way too buff to be me. Large? Yep, that's exactly how big I am, you know? No, it's probably more like... I'm not that thin, and I'm not that huge. I would go, like, somewhere like me right here. Even though that looks pretty thin, man. I'm a thin man from XCOM. That seems legit. That does not look like me at all. But whatever. Fine. Guy Fury, what's up, man? It's good to see ya. Guy Fury says, we've had Space Mike. It's time for highly irradiated post-apocalyptic Mike. I need to work on that nickname, I admit. Nuclear Mike. Hey, that looks pretty good. Nuclear Mike, Fallout, Mike? I don't know. Post-apocalyptic Mike seems legit. Alright, I think we're good. Now let's enter a name. Firm character? Yep, looks nothing like me, but it's okay. Fine. Auto-saving. What's my name, though? Hey, is this FOV90? Nora.
Hun.
Why don't you see if breakfast is ready? I'm hurrying up. Don't worry.
The volume looks kind of low. Volume, the audio is all the way up though, right? Yeah, oh wait, no, voice isn't all the way up. No, turn that up, man. Who didn't have the voice all the way up? All right.
I'll just be a minute. Just getting ready.
Definitely a little bit louder. Definitely a little bit louder. You can switch FOV and commands in game, I think. Does that screw me up from not getting achievements? Well, we'll hold off on that. I think that's what happened in New Vegas. I would always change my FOV to 90, and then I would stop getting achievements, but then I had to find a mod that I was able to install. That way I could get achievements by after touching the console commands and stuff. Door close. Mr. Handy, dude.
Yeah, let Codsworth take care of it.
Codsworth. Okay, what name am I going to go with? Do I just go with Mike? Do I go with my nickname? I don't know. Will people be able to say Mikey in this game? Seems like it's a common, you know... Oh god, we're listening to music. It's going to mute the VOD. That's alright, it's whatever. This feels like control. Quick save is F9. Dang, that's way over there. Okay. Oh wait, no, F5, never mind. Right there. Look sensitivity. Now you gotta turn that look up a little bit there. We're playing this on very hard. There we go, that looks a little bit better. Here. Do I, is this put, you put this on?
War never changes. Got that right. No need to get dressed twice.
Blue dress. That there. Alright, so it looks like we're in a neighborhood, nothing bad has happened yet. Keep going.
Sir, your coffee. 173.5 degree Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just delivered.
How come the subtitles aren't on? What the heck, man? Sugar bombs.
Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar.
Good. Man, look at that. You can see the trees moving. Vault Tech, October 12th. Okay, so the stuff hasn't happened yet.
Oh, sounds like someone made a sticky. I shall attend to young Shaw.
Abby crying.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
Great, he is. Halloween, man. Quick Googling says that console commands don't disable achievements. Okay, good then. Alright. FOV 90, I think. Script command not found. Okay, well, I don't know how to change the FOV then. Never mind. Gotta try survival if you ever do a playthrough off cam, my dude. Tons of fun. If you enjoy dying, in agony in the post-apocalypse. Yeah, we're playing on very hard right now. One of the main draws for for not playing survival the first time
it's probably that salesman.
Is no fast traveling. Kind of sucks. Not a fan of that though. With the space. There we go. Ha, ah, much better.
Referring, of course, to a great national pastime, baseball.
Lol. This afternoon, right here in the city, Alt Tech there. Swatting sultans will swing for the fences. I just want to walk around and look at stuff. The American flag.
Good old USA.
America. Law diploma. Who's the doctor here?
Come on, just answer the door and he'll go away.
I'm so proud of her.
Wait, someone rang the doorbell? I know they did. Hang on.
Hey, hon.
Can you get the door? Whenever I answer, he just asks for you over and over.
Grognak comic.
Grognak the Barbarian in the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
Dude, Bat Babies, man. Drink coffee? No, we drink Nuka-Cola here, alright?
No, he's not gonna give up.
Look, I know. I need to open my Nuka-Cola, okay? I've got a Nuka-Cola right here. I can't show you the name for legal reasons. Let's open it up, man. Is it Twist? Nope, it's not Twist. I've got to do the other thing. Alright.
Honey, do you mind getting the door?
It's Nuka freaking cola, it's so good. Alright, I'll answer the door. Alright.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Hey, the mod worked! I didn't suck at installing a mod. Vault-Tec, remind me again.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Okay. I don't know why there isn't subtitles happening here, but we'll fix that a little bit later. It does not look anything like me, Jesus. Okay. So we know what Vault-Tec is, alright? We've played all the Fallout games except this one. We know what Vault-Tec is. This is this right now.
Hello?
Oh, hi. Yeah, I didn't know there was a timer here. The current year is 2077. We know what happens a little bit later in this month. But my character doesn't. So I'm gonna play dumb. What's so important?
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think. If you catch my meaning... Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Vault 111. I think the voiceover volume sounds a little bit low. It's all the way up. So the only other way that I could turn it up is if I up like my overall volume in the volume mixer.
I'm but in a bit of a rush.
You guys should still be able to hear it, I guess. There's room for my entire family, right?
But there's room for my entire family, right?
Of course. Minus your robot, naturally.
My robot?
You're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Sarcastic, I can't wait for the world to end. Tell me more about this vault. I don't really want to cut off dialogue with this guy. I want to hear what he has to say.
Tell me more about this vault.
Oh, it has all the amenities of the modern home, I assure you. Not to mention total protection from nuclear radiation and hostile mutants. A better future underground. It's not only our mission, it's our passion.
Okay. Can't wait for the world to end. I want to hear what happens after that.
No, I can't wait for the world to end.
That's the spirit. Now, let's see.
Hey, all right, dude.